Hello everyone, what's up? Welcome to another quick edit video. This time with a cool mountain landscape from the Swiss Alps above St. Moritz. And for this shot I want to use Adobe Lightroom Classic to apply a very contrast-rich, almost black and white-like style. And later maybe also make use of the Nick Collection plugin. But first, here are the before and after images. Alright, then let's first go down to the Lens Correction tab and activate those two settings. Next I want to change the camera profile to Adobe Standard. By the way, I already have applied some cropping on this image just to make the subject a little more interesting, since the bottom part and especially the left side are a little bit boring, so by cropping the image I put much more attention to the mountain in the center, and that's exactly what I want for this image. But let's continue with the editing. Right now there is not much contrast going on. You can also see that at the histogram, since all the tones are pretty much in the same range here. Now to add the contrast, I'm starting by dropping the exposure first. And I'm going really low here. Once I've done this, I can simply pull up the whites. And with just those two adjustments, the image got much more contrast already. Now I can continue adding contrast by increasing the highlights. But of course, here it's important to be careful to not overexpose anything, since with this slider, I obviously only target highlights. So let's see, I don't want to overdo it, so let's go with something like this. And then I also, of course, can just add some contrast. When we compare the before and after, you can see there is much, much more contrast going on. But also the colors start to look a little bit weird. Actually, let's change the white balance to cloudy. And that fixes the color problem by increasing the temperature. I think I still want to have some more base saturation, so let's add a little bit of vibrance. Alright. Next, I want to have some more detail in this picture, so I'm increasing the clarity. And at the same time, I want to have a subtle, soft look over the whole image, so I'm dropping the texture. Alright. We can bring some more attention to the center part by darkening the top of the image, and for this I'm using a gradiated filter, just like this, and in here I'm simply dropping the exposure. And let's also drop the texture to make this area a little softer and thus reduce the noise in here. Alright, that improves the image quite a bit. Then next, let's continue in the HSL tab. I think I might need to drop the blue saturation just a bit. And then I'm using the split toning to apply a subtle cold color tone to the shadows. And here let's drop the strength to not make it too saturated. Alright, that looks pretty awesome, I think. Of course, I'm also sharpening this picture. And finally, I want to apply a little vignetting. Okay, this looks pretty good. Now, there are a few sensor spots in this image. And since I'm not using Photoshop, I'm using the spot removal tool. And just to be safe, I'm activating the visualize spot settings. Let's reduce the amount here. And now you can see the spots are easier to discover. Now that would be pretty much it, but I do want to check the Nick Collection plugin in case there might be some nice effects to add. So let's open this in Color Effects Pro 4. And for those kind of images, I think some dreamy look works pretty nice. And in this case, I'm using the classical soft focus. And under the method menu, I'm going with the first diffusion method, I think, because it has some nice highlights. And then let's hit save. All right, and that is it for editing this almost black and white mountainscape image. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions, then feel free to ask in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.